Given the increasing cases of malaria in the country, the Uganda Cancer Institute has kicked off a study of the genetically engineered mosquitoes to fight malaria. These mosquitoes will be feeding on existing mosquitoes that cause malaria. Activists have started sensitizing islanders on Jana Island about the new study project about using the genetically modified mosquitoes to fight malaria.
GMOs, these GMOs are a different, a new version of the other one. Mm-hmm. So these GMOs, the other one, they would go in the lab, they do risk assessment, they try everything to see that everything is done according to what the environment, to the plants, to everything. But these GMOs specifically do not require the lab risk and whatever. Their risk assessment is tried out.
Barbara Ntabiruki, a lawyer and an activist, has cited out some of the effects which they want the government to consider before rolling out the genetic mosquitoes.
One of the side effects is the effect to the environment. This project has the capacity of eliminating populations, and that may have unexpected consequences. For example, if you're going to release a gene drive mosquito into the environment, this gene drive could mutate. Could be something else, and all these risks are not discussed with the community.
In a bid to fight malaria, the government has used a number of methods, including the recent rollout of mosquito nets campaign across the country. Robert Sebalamu, an environmentalist, has appealed for more enhancement of these programs.
It comes to these genetically modified organs. A lot of study is supposed to be done because we actually don't know what can be the repercussions and what can be really the products.
Though mosquitoes are harmful to people, Bambalaza Wesemakula, an activist and resident, has cited out other importances towards aquatic life and plants. He further appealed to the government for more scrutinization of his project before it is rolled out.
If you kill mosquitoes, you eliminate them, you are eliminating much from our environment, especially the plant system. So, and therefore, because Kalangala, we depend on fish as our economic activity. We depend on tourism. So in the long run, when you eliminate mosquitoes, the plants that bring tourists will not be here. The plant, the insects, the birds that come to feed on these mosquitoes will not be there. Eventually, even the tourism sector will be hampered with.
Jana residents, led by their chairperson while in his engagement at Lakeview Hotel in Kalangala, have narrated their experience upon the ongoing study.
Nemaliriye nyini ngatuma. Netunga mangai valese project team. Osanga china kendeza uko bwadde mchitunzo. Somesa. Ngiriji bagenda kutande okuzitam.
According to the National Institute of Public Health, malaria is endemic in Uganda, covering 95% of the country, affecting over 90% of the population, with up to 20% of the deaths. Story compiled by Samuel Nkuba for the news in Kalangala.